into a position where they have to get aggressive or retreat.
Doors down. Ethan, hold on. Hold on, yeah, Kang, hold on. The timing, they're gonna get detained. Three players. Jorgamo, he's hunting them. Demon One's there. Hold on, has to try and defend his team. And now look at them. Stand and deliver. Nobody's down. And EG against all odds.
This was the first of 9 straight rounds won by EG. Just goes to show that even the simplest, least winnable of rounds can shift momentum in an instant when you play them right. Hey everyone, welcome back to Cypher Valorant. Today we're looking at some of the best eco rounds in Valorant's tournament history. When a round rife with hurdles gives you the opportunity to profit, you take it every single time. And if you're a pro, you do it well. Just look at this remarkable performance from Edward Gaming in Tokyo.
Is that gonna make no subtleties of this? Three players are here, one a little more dedicated than the others, and that's going to be nobody. And actually, fights what? Two! How do you get two in that? That shouldn't have happened, and neither should have that. Hold on, finding connection with that sheriff has put problems to Loud. Bullish in approach and left in tatters. You got less than twoies. They've lost down on Zarek, and Kangkang's there. Oh, come on! EDG's shattering.
Strong performances. Scary, still putting up numbers. I feel like Sushi Boys is the one that I now need to see if they're going to do well.
They heard the push on short. They think there's at least 2 players, maybe 3, coming up on A. They want to go to the garage, but they don't know. It's scary. It's sat right here inside the smoke. It's so nasty. A frenzy in hand. He's able to take so much damage.
Oh.
That could have been greater, but Angel's low. It gives a chance to the players on the site still holding on. The Classic's doing so much damage, and they'll win it. Xertia!
Tick down. 35 seconds left on the clock, and I think the B-side play looks fairly obvious.
Oh no, the shorty's got one, and now it's up close. Swapped out to a Vandal. BNJ already got a second. Down below, he's dealt with. A bookie's come through for more. What is that? Bezzard, he's got a double with a bookie, and Boaster's 1 HP. NIP have just come into this round with a shorty and some pistol stuff.
I'm gonna hit back towards B from mid. There's only 20 seconds left on the clock. We have to go for a nice little smoke onto the main side so we can focus on the heavens. And that's 7-3. Now though, gravity well. Corner's not checked. Somehow a prime giving.
One of the cleanest ecos we've seen from an American team, though it only took 2 players to get it done. Gorgeous Blade Storm by 7, and Zabroza kept that energy going. Beautifully played. Here's a clutch in Copenhagen that sees the whole of Fnatic needing to pull their weight to come away with the round.
Durka and Alfia feel like there's nobody here, but
30 seconds left.
With the fact that they didn't see anybody towards tiles, here, now the utility comes through, and they're ready for it.
Fury? Being used to clear the corner, Durka, he's been spotted out. Off to the side, the positioning was known, Melzer hunts him down. And now they work their way into the side, jumping around, making sure they can avoid it, Alfia! The shots finding him, the damage is still done. He set his team up for success. But right now, it's the rest of the Fnatic players that have to capitalize. A beautiful horn. The spike needs to be stuck. And the setup is there.
An available orb, which it's going to be this one.
Or is it? Map's made out of paper. Lance gives it up, though. He realized that it wasn't being played for his knives. All the way into mid, gliding across as the Lombard. What is that?
Wow.
Dash forwards, right click to the face. Yampi, he's no more. He's handed over a rifle. There's a peak timing. Clean movement. Satchel pushing him back, setting it up. It's not a favorable fight for him, but they do back away evenly. Safe still alive, though.
Seems like a good time for a Kangkang round.
Yeah, why not? Pull one out when your team needs it. That is really scared that somebody could have been pushed inside of the zone smoke. And yeah, well, he's fearful of man. Looks
like. Yeah, I think it is. I just spotted it on the drive.
Did you see it? Okay, and Hunter's Fury now invested as well. Catch a tag, I think. What? Uh-oh, that stack's gone as well. This is not the round you're meant to be losing this. King's found Buzz. It was never meant to be this round. They've got nothing. Taco's still top mid.
This is it. This is just the crack starting to show here. The pressure getting to them.
This is the one to try and pull it off in. Well, it's not looking great already, is it? Door looks shut here in this round. Dives on in. It's the un.
Here comes Envy looking to pick someone off through lobby. He's going to get one. Make it. Jesse picking up a second. All right. And all of a sudden, I mean, potential to upgrade. Potential now for Team Secret to take a cheeky eco round. Dubstep. Oh, the timing!
What?
The
oh my god!
Headshot! You've got to be kidding me! And all of a sudden now, Team Secret upgrading the gun. Dubstep about to his life. Down goes Foxy.
If there was ever any doubt in the potential Team Secrets players had across the season, this match opener was where those got shut down. TS owned this map against DRX, and Dubstep was a key part of that. The especially rare Sheriff Collat to cap off a wild round. Let's take it all the way back to week one of Pacific, where the two teams playing were destined to head in opposite directions.
Trying to get additional intel too, but no. There you go. They're going in for a Jing. He's blast packed all over. Venkai getting a quick double. How is he doing this up by the stairs? Suggest trying to do what he can too, but Defy just comes up from behind. Paper Rex. They've come out of nowhere to find this Thrifty.
Completely stunned up. Has to disappear. But that gives Arcade control, and these pistols, Shazam falls. And we've got ourselves actually a situation where maybe he recovers a gun. Yes, pens up close.
Oh, but he's in the smoke. The spam's through. Understands there's someone there.
Whoa!
They've just destroyed Sentinels.
That was embarrassing.
They have no guns.
Push forwards right in between pyramids, making waves on the map. He will eventually be dealt with, though, and it's a great timing on top of it. Yampi uses the chaos of the situation, the chaos of the ultimate, to take a great fight.
Whoa, got a shot!
Shut down Kankan.
Insane 1-2 play from Screamin' Yampi. And they've got EDG sweating right now.
Yeah, this should have been an easy one for them.
How many times have we said that? What is this, the third anti-eco that EDG are about to lose?
One enemy remaining.
Again, Yampi just knows the right timings to take. I was too distracted, and there's your Thrifty win.
Big dink.
That hurts. Huge.
Nice swing from
traded
Yang.
Right back, yeah. Stun hunting, finds a second. The flash timing is gorgeous. He gets in, gets a kill, gets out.
And that's all the way from back screens that Victor threw that flash. Oh, he's just picking them apart with his headhunter. And they might get their first eco win on the board.
I mean, guess why do you need to win pistols if you've got headhunter on the other side in the second round, huh?
Oh my.
Yep, that's four. Has he fired four bullets? He's got three bullets left. He's going to get the chance at the A. Steph on the other side.
That was five free kills for Ye, and it took him six headhunter bullets. I cannot undersell how well played that was on each and every kill, never allowing an opportunity for anyone else to even touch him. He caught every member of X set lacking. Here's a clutch from Foot's debut on the world stage.
In the top mid. Got the creep up and... Oh, Mosh!
What?
What is that? Flick finds a second for his troubles. And now Kiwi's going to go for the push, and he's going to get them both.
I am stunned, dazed, and confused, but...
He's got a shorty.
Yeah, but...
He knows he's close, but he's still going to challenge it.
Oh, what a mistake in the end. It could have been some...
You're looking at a Sage wall. I mean, imagine if you still had one right now. Pop it down. There's a Shock Dart kill on the Nags. That's a big blow right away. The Operator really not connecting. I mean, he's just gone in. Nukia giving a kill for free. And Gelsic in the corner. He takes three kills. And Kellogg's is all alone. The Operator looking to run and save, but he can't even get away.
What?
Control of this, which is the thing. Oh, I mean, the lag post plant. Try and deal with a couple of these players now starting to walk their way up.
Yeah, they're actually used.
I mean, everybody is playing down short, and they don't have post-plant lineups particularly. No Molly, you know, no big ultimates to work with. Tap, Paranoia, a bit further forward here, near side. This is
Rough, come! This is more than Rough, this is looking like an absolute round win!
They can get the plant down. And they can start doing a bit of damage. Now, Navera's kept in the back of his mind. He knew that Laz was going to be lurking, and it's the right call to be making. So can the three of them do anything from the site? That's going to be the harder part here, is trying to make any damage come through. Yeah, Dap's still alive, but he's got to have a lot more of that where that just came from. And Sugar Zero dives in. The headhunter! Oh, Sugar Zero, what a way to do it! And Dap still stands, has to hit the shot, and it's Soulcast on the other side, a man who's had an up-and-down performance! And now
there was moment after moment of this during Zeta Division's Cinderella run through Reykjavik. Sugar Zero ended the event as its 11th best player, and Zeta finished 3rd, their best result in international history. Speaking of record finishes, how's about some evil geniuses?
This?
But what is that?
Come on.
Power. Oh.
Stunning.
We have had some of the... Some of the...
See where it was. Okay. Oh, it's just beautiful to watch, isn't it?
Now show me a smile.
Oh,
that
yeah.
is clean
oh, yeah,
as
yeah,
any
yeah, yeah.
seconds ago.
Oh, Shorty! What? Are you serious?
Esperanza! Oh, he does not care. He says, yeah. I'll just rush this down and the rest of the team is doing much of the same.
All right, TS hiding.
It's not even a massive investment from them.
Oh my god.
The weapon upgrades are huge.
Flapping around with her arms like a bird. He's over here.
TS, can you do anything at all? He's wary about the counter swing, but everybody's approaching through the.
It's the jet. No flashes. It's only really Zephyr's utility. Unfortunately, with him coming off that sky, they lose that second layer.
Stack here, Mike.
With Zelsis coming onto the Sage, it's the same thing once again.
Well, we do have a stack on the other side now. Four players. Let's see. What can they do? It's just waiting now. Marco finds leaf. That's not ideal.
Bars.
Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. This is not how it happens, right? Oh, in the second round after you did the flawless work and you asked a lot of Ye. Says he needs to be one of the main proponents here.
Vanity has a rifle, though.
Okay, that's been heard.
Potential here, seeing as it's still just classics for DRX.
Can they get the spike back? Yeah, okay, Ye's got that. Oh, but he'll go down for it! Is this how they get to 12? Unreal Vanities!
The last chance for Cloud9 to make a comeback here. Their fate was sealed, and we would have to wait weeks before we saw them perform their best. But that's what you get when you play DRX. But when talking about Pacific favorites, even the deities can't be perfect.
Cut them down. It'd be gonna be good for one. Dispatch.
Oh my god!
There's the knife kill we were looking for! And off the back of it!
Starting lean towards C. And look, it ran just on the other side of the smoke.
There, actually, the smoke that K-Knight is throwing down is a lot of a gap into that site. That's why DRX uses it to look to break mollies. But Rin is playing an off angle into his molly for it. So anybody who comes through is just going to get barrel stuff. That's really nicely done. Good details there from Billy Billy.
It's so difficult. It's clean, and it's an ace from Rin.
Now the flash is coming on in. There's so much being poured into this. The swing's good, though. Gives him a little bit of timing. Wait, well, what? Buckle! He just got... No way, DRX! Are they seriously going to do this? Yes, they are! Yeah, he can do nothing but sit back and watch. DRX are not out of it.
A site completely open now as Foot gamble in the opposite direction. Running all the way down!
Cryo's holding that angle alone. Listen, when you're being swarmed by that many players, you give up a rifle.
Whoa, this is dangerous now.
Dash to the side, Blade Storm as well! Kiwi! An absolute magical moment!
A storm of punishes to take us out. Thanks so much for watching. If you want to see more tournament highlights, check out our LA Champions video. Let us know in the comments what you want to see next, and subscribe to never miss another upload. Until next time!